y'all. My name is Holly. Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be doing a Valentine's Day home tour, and I'm so excited about this one. I'm not going to lie, Valentine's is like my least favorite holiday to decorate for because I don't ever really know how to decorate. It's still winter month, but all the Valentine's Day decorations, they're all spring. So I always have the hardest time trying to figure out what to do and how I want to decorate our home. But if you've been following me already and keeping up with me, you know that I found the perfect picture for over our buffet in our dining room. And so I just went with that theme, and I'm so excited to share with y'all what all I came up with for this new season. And also, I'm going to be doing another collab with my really good friend. I'm just going to go ahead and say my best friend, Miranda, because we like talk every day. We're constantly going around our homes, like showing each other ideas, giving each other ideas on what to decorate, how to decorate our home, how to change things up. So we've had a lot of fun working together. And so I'm so excited to be sharing with y'all both of our home tours today. So after you check out mine today, go over and look at hers. Tell her I sent you. Show her some love. She is so sweet. I have really just fallen so much in love with her. She's actually from Kentucky. And so it's just been a lot of fun to like have a best friend that you've just met through social media, through YouTube, and just connect so well with. So please go over to her channel and show her some love. She's taught me a lot of things. I've taught her a few things. And so it's just been a lot of fun. And we've been able to post more videos because of bouncing ideas off of one another. And since it is Valentine's Day, I wanted to tell you just a little bit background of Drew and I, since he is my love. Drew and I have been dating since 2008. We started dating my senior year in high school and his junior year. He's exactly 11 months younger than me. His birthday is May 18th and mine is June 18th. We went to the same tiny little school. It was K through 12 and just a very, very small school. And I went there K through 12. He went there K through 12. We've known of each other like our whole life, but we didn't really get together until I heard some of our mutual friends tell me that he had a crush on me. And so I've pretty much been inseparable ever since. So again, we started dating in December of 2008, and then we got married in August 25th, 2012. What's the math on that? How many years have we been together? So this August will be 8 years of us being married. And so we've went through a few different moves, and like y'all all know, we're in a double wide right now. We're planning on actually selling the double wide at some point in our life. We are living on the family farm. And so at some point our plans in life are to sell the double wide and build a smaller farmhouse right here on the farm. So if you follow us on Simply Lake and Lace on Instagram or Facebook, you will see him over there a lot more. He doesn't really like to be on YouTube very much. I have to like drag him into the videos every now and then, but he definitely will show out on Instagram sometimes. So you'll have to go follow me over there and kind of keep up with our daily lives. But if you're not new to my channel, then you already know most of all of this. But if you're new, then I did want to go ahead and give y'all a little background of who I am and who I'm married to, since this is a Valentine's Day video. So I hope that y'all enjoyed this little home tour that I have put together for y'all. For you, as always, it is raining outside. It is a very nasty day here in Alabama. So I'm going to try to talk really loud so you can hear me over the rain. And so over here, same setup, just threw some Valentine's Day decor. I actually made this garland. I got this. It's actually just paper. They come in a pack of the white from Hobby Lobby. You can get a pack of the white and the pack of the red. They come in different colors and sizes. And then I actually tea stained these. So they weren't so bright white, and then I just hung them with twine, and then I kept the cute little lights up from Christmas because I actually loved how they looked with all of this. Just kind of set it for Valentine's Day. Seen some of my other videos, then you know that Welcome to the Farm sign, I would have loved to have like a little Valentine's Day quote or something, some kind of sign up there. I ran out of time looking for things, and I'm gonna try to go probably find one or a couple of them because I have another place that I wanted to put one in our bedroom after the season where I can get it on clearance, because y'all know that I love a deal. And then we have my record player, and I love this thing. We have some Disney in it right now, but it's actually a little disc player also, a little DVD player, and it has a cassette player. And then my pretty roses, but they have about died on me. I could probably take these white ones out and the red ones and the eucalyptus would still be fine. But I got those at Trader Joe's a couple of weeks ago, and you can't do Valentine's Day without a thing of roses. And then over here we have Miss Darla. And y'all saw me decorate the foyer already. There is a foyer, a decorate with me for Valentine's Day for the four-year video, and I'll go ahead and link that. So I won't go into too much detail because y'all have already seen it. That is a song that I printed off. It's a song that I walked down the aisle to. And then Miss Darla did not get ironed, and I did not even realize that until I started doing this video. So she's still a little wrinkly. And then I did find some Valentine's Day candies at the Dollar Tree that I put in our little candy machine. Darla looks awful. I'm so sorry. I forgot all about ironing her out. From the foyer, you walk on into the dining room. And this is the picture that I found at the thrift store that inspired me for the rest of the house. And I have done lots of different hauls that you can go check out on my video, like shopping with me for Valentine's Day. And so you can see all the details on where I purchased all of this. I have some of our Nature Red displayed on a wine rack. And then I love our little cookie jar with the little heart. That is actually Velcroed on. It's by Cotton Colors. And so every season I change out the theme. And so I just took the reindeer head off and now I have the cute little heart. And then right here, I had a beautiful centerpiece and I actually took a picture of it and it's on my Instagram, but I will insert it here so you can see what it looks like. And everything started kind of dying out, so I just took this dough bowl and laid everything in here to finish drying out. But I think it's really pretty. I wanted the theme for Valentine's Day. I've seen a bunch of different ones, very bright, airy, and springy, and I was going to try to go with more wintry, but it's a good transition for me. It's very romantic looking. And so where I was getting inspiration off Pinterest was typing in February wedding decor ideas, or like January. And that's the theme that I was more so going with for Valentine's Day, more of a romantic feel. This little bar cart is kind of in the way. I do not know where to put it. It's pretty tight right here, but I need to find another place to move it. But for right now, it's just on this little wall. And then I got this candle arbor that was originally when I bought it, supposed to go on the buffet table. And then I found the wine rack. So I just put it over here for now. And so right behind me, I'm actually standing in the dining room. Y'all can see where we are. So this is the foyer over here, the little bar cart, the dining room, and then the kitchen. If you follow me on Instagram, then you know what I did with this brick backsplash, and it has changed the look of our kitchen. Oh my goodness. So it took me a second to talk Drew into letting me do this because he thought I was crazy, lost my mind, but I was like, no, I'm doing it. And so we'll get up closer and I'll show you. And so I had these nice little velvet placemats I was going to use for our dining room table, but it just didn't look right. And so I threw them up here by accident and loved it. Oh, it just dressed up our island. I thought it was so pretty. And so those will stay there until the end of February. And then we'll just talk about the new things. Oh, right here. So I have my little print-offs, a Valentine's bucket list. I have loved doing this. Just finding things on Pinterest that's kind of fun for the season and putting up on the refrigerator. I used to like a nice clean refrigerator, but now I just really love seeing this stuff. So I have a Valentine bucket list. Lots of fun things. Thought the little girl was cute. A fun little quote that looked Valentine's-y. And then my cousin Kayla showed me this, and this is a Valentine's Day diffuser blend. And so right now I have the candlelit dinner in my Aria diffuser, which I'm about to show you, and then the candy hearts and the one behind me. And so it's just little diffuser blends because y'all know I don't use candles anymore. I only use my diffusers, and so this gives me the Valentine's Day scents for the house. Okay, we'll go over here. So I hung up some string lights. And it is nasty outside, y'all. It would have been pretty if I would have turned my lights on out there, but I didn't want to get wet. So I have little string lights hanging right here. Oh, I just love it so much. Like, I just cannot tell y'all how much that I love this brick backsplash. And y'all are really going to die whenever I tell y'all what it is. Go ahead and get right up on it. This is wallpaper, guys. Just wallpaper. And what I did is I bought it off of my Amazon shop. You can go to my Amazon shop, I'll link it below. Or if you follow me on Instagram, you can go to my bio and my Amazon is linked there. And then I have this wallpaper and I have different ones linked, but I had this one that I used in our kitchen linked in there. And it was so easy to put up. I did this all by myself. And so what I did is I just cut it out in little sections. I actually just had it thumbtacked up. And then I went back with some double-sided tape and just taped it to the wall. Now I was going to actually like paste it on the wall with the wallpaper glue. But since we're planning on selling our home, I really didn't want to do that to the new homeowners in case they didn't love it. And so I just taped it up there. So whenever I get tired of it, I can just rip it down. It's so easy and so cheap, y'all. This took me less than $20 to do this. So right over here on this corner, this has pretty much stayed the same. I had my Aria going, and this is the one for the candlelit dinner. It's geranium, cedarwood, patchouli, and orange, and it smells so pretty. This diffuser is a showstopper. Absolutely love it in here. And then I just have some of my oils down on the bottom. And then I have some plants, as you can see, in our windows. I love me some Real House plants. These actually came from my grandma's yard. It's just ivy that was like taking over her yard and growing up on her brick and on her exterior of her home. It was just so pretty. So I actually just ripped those suckers right out of the ground and trimmed them up a good bit, put them in a glass of water. They will re-root, and it just adds a pop of tall green. Oh, it's beautiful. I love it. And then this one is new also. You saw this in one of my new hauls. And this one is really good for purifying the air. Houseplants are amazing for purifying the air. So that's why I have them all over my home, and I love watching them grow. And so then I got this new to water my plants with. I love this little copper thing. It's so pretty. And then over here at my little coffee bar station, Miss Althea actually got me this little mug from Home Goods, and it is so cute. I love it. And then I found this at the thrift store, and so this holds all of my, y'all know every season I love just collecting and buying these little fun paper plates to eat off of. And so I got all of these from different places, but just a really cute, easy, cheap, and very convenient way to decorate for each season. And then over here, I just have these little stir sticks that I got, I think, from like Home Goods, TJ Maxx, or Target, one of those places. And then some cute little Valentine's Day straws over here. And then this is what I make my coffee, cappuccino, and things like that with. I don't have a Keurig anymore. I thought this was a little bit more fun, kind of dressed up the area a little bit. And then over here, we have a cute little Happy Valentine's Day dish towel. And then we have Sweet Miss Dolly up here. And I'm loving the brick backsplash. It just makes a world of difference. And then over here on the kitchen island, I just bought some cupcakes. And they're really good too. I had one last night for supper. So when I think of Valentine's Day, I think of like roses and chocolate and a bunch of sweets and red and pink. And so this was just fun to put over here to decorate this little space. And then I've had those out since Christmas. And then we'll go on to the living room. As you can see in the living room, I still have my string lights up. My mom asked me when she came over here to help me clean, because we had a little fun Oli party over here this past weekend. And mom came to help me clean my house and see my Valentine's Day decorations. And she said, okay, when are you taking your string lights down? And I was like, not anytime soon. I love them. She said, Holly, have you heard the word tacky? I was like, yes, but I don't care. I love it. And she said, well, when I walk in, that's the first thing I see is the string lights. I'm like, perfect. That's what I want. It's so much fun to have the lights off at night, watching a fun little romantic movie, have the diffusers going. It just sets the mood. I just love it. I just brought like the outside string lights in, and it has just been so much fun for me. And Drew really likes it too, so it doesn't matter if y'all like it or not. Drew and I do, so it makes us happy. It's our home. Okay, now we're going to come over here to behind the couch. I cleaned out some of my oils. I got to add some more up here. I just realized they're all missing. So I have my diffuser going, and that one is filled with the Candy Hearts diffuser blend. And then I have this little book. It looks a little Valentine's Day-ish. I wanted a book about roses right here. I couldn't ever find one at the thrift store. So I saw I had this one. And this is just the chemical-free home face and body. And then behind it, I have the chemical-free home for housekeeping. I think that I had these linked in my Amazon shop. But these are just, let me show you this because I know y'all are going to ask about them. They're just ways. We don't use any toxic cleaners or anything in our home anymore. So this is just different recipes and stuff you can use with essential oils or like virgin coconut oil, just very natural things. And the same thing with this chemical-free home for housekeeping. So that's what that's about, in case y'all were wondering. But I just thought that was pretty displayed there. And then my same little plant. I kept my little red bird because I thought he was fun for Valentine's Day.
My clock is not right. I need new batteries. And then those are really pretty lit up at night, those little LED candles. And then I wanted to show you, so basically everything in here stayed the same, but I thought this was fun. So this little bag, I think used to be a little cassette holder, but it reminded me of like a little mail carrier holder. And so I put all of mine and Drew's old Valentine's Day cards in here. And so I thought that was really cute. I know you can't see it very well in here, but I know that I have them collected in there. And then we have the mirrors that's looking into the foyer. I mean the windows, not the mirrors. And then over here, we have the little phone stuck on the wall. And then, this is a bookshelf that was actually in my parents' garage for forever, held all of Daddy's tools, and I actually got it and cleaned it up, took the two doors off, and then made it as a bookcase. And then I was going to get some like red or pink throw pillows for Valentine's Day, but I just loved my pillow. They looked really bad right now. They need to be fluffed. So I had these on there for Christmas, and I just loved them so much. I did not want to get rid of them. I still loved them. I did not want to go out and buy new pillows whenever. I still absolutely loved these. And so I think it works for Valentine's Day. I think they're really pretty. I added the little gold pillow over here. And then over here, this is fun. So I just added some red books. This one is actually a devotional, but these are just little Valentine's Day books. And this one I loved. It's Grow Old Along With Me, The Best Is Yet To Be. Y'all know that sign that you can buy from Magnolia that Chip and Joe put in people's houses. And actually somebody gave us that sign for, I think it was my birthday a few years ago at my old job, and it's hanging up in our bathroom. So whenever I saw this book, I had to get it. And then of course this roses, it was just a beautiful cover. And so that's how I decorated right here for Valentine's Day. Just super easy and very cheap. And then our fireplace, I just have this fun little Ray Dunn sign that says Happy Valentine's Day. I'll get closer to it in a second. Well, I guess I'll go ahead and get up there now so you can see it. But I have these fun little glitter antlers that I got from a little boutique years ago. And then it has dried eucalyptus. And then these are just those copper light fairy lights that are really pretty whenever they're turned on at night to light up the little area. Back, go this way. These were paper whites. They're dying off now, but they still had some green to them. And this cute little red bird, so I just stuck it here. This was in our bathroom window sill, but I changed that out. I needed some green over here, so I brought it over this way. And then this is new, Drew's little area. And so we have this cute little table that I purchased from Kirkland's. I have a video on that, putting it together, me decorating over here. And then I put this little plant over here. This actually used to be in our shower, this plant. And I believe this is called a pothos plant. And these are like super easy. If you're just starting out with house plants, pothos, and I'm not going to pronounce this right, fidendrils or something. I'll try to find it. And let y'all know what it's called. But those are like the easiest houseplants to take care of. It's hard to kill them, and they're very, very good for purifying your air. And they grow like crazy. I love it. And then this is one of my new favorites, this little post office box that I found at the antique booth whenever I went shopping at Carly's booth. This was in a booth kind of close to hers. And then these little roses are just beautiful. They were $1.25 a piece, so I got half a dozen, and they feel so real. Like they just have that silkiness like a real rose. And so I thought that was so pretty over here, beside Drew's little corner. Just added that pop of green, just a little bit of color in here. I really loved how that turned out. And the bench used to be on this side, and then I moved it over here, and I got this beautiful pillow. I did a haul on that from Home Goods. Let me just get closer to it because it's beautiful. I love the sequins in it. It's beautiful. The bead detail is perfect. And then I got this beautiful wreath at Hobby Lobby for half off, and it was $25, and it's just dried eucalyptus, and it is so pretty. Anything real or like dried that I can decorate with and not have to use so many faux plants, it just really makes our house feel really homey. A quick scan this way so you can see how it flows. And then we will head into the bedroom. So this has stayed the same since the winter home tour. I just added a fun little Valentine's Day heart. I think I got that at Hobby Lobby like years ago, but I just put that there for a pop of color. And then into our bedroom. I really loved how it turned out. Y'all, it was so easy to decorate for Valentine's Day because I just used a lot of Christmas decorations that I had out. And so this blanket is new. My cousin Kayla got this for me, and it came from Dollar General. She paid $4 for hers, and she couldn't find mine on clearance, but still, that was a deal. This is so pretty. Yeah, I really just dressed up the room with warm blankets, red, white, this beautiful faux animal fur. And then I had the faux fur white pillows, and then just the red velvet pillow, and I think it's just pretty. It's just real simple and elegant looking. And then on each side of the nightstands, I have our diffusers, and then both of them are from Young Living. And then I just, let me get closer, some of our oils. And then I have I got these, this arrangement at Hobby Lobby, and so I did a haul on those also. And then a little thing of eucalyptus in the back. I wanted to put real roses in here, but I'm glad that I didn't, because they would have died before I got to film. And so it was just easier to have some plants that were going to stay alive for me. And I really love how those look. And Drew built this headboard for me. I have to tell that in like every video, because everybody always asks where I got my headboard, and Drew made it for me. And so I love it. I think it's so pretty. And the same thing on Drew's nightstand. He just has his diffuser, a little wood block with his oils, and the same little arrangement. And over to this side of the room. And so this is new. Y'all saw that I got that at Carly's booth, and it just looks so good in our bedroom. I love how the blue matches the chair. It's just so pretty. I love it so much. That was less than $20, that picture was. And then this stayed the same since winter. Y'all have already seen my new mirror, but I got a new plant, a peace lily, and this is where I put it. And it, I repotted it, and it's doing really good. Let's see. I love this. Anyway, this is called a peace lily. This is an easy plant to keep alive also. Very easy indoor plant. And then we'll spin over this way to the fireplace. And that has, well, no, it didn't. I did have something else right here, but I added these little mercury glass candles. And so I think those are really pretty and elegant over here. And everybody always asks where I got that fireplace, and that fireplace came from the Facebook online yard sale. So you can get them online at like Home Depot, Lowe's, Big Lots, Wayfair, but we got ours for a really good deal. And then we will open the sliding door, and we will go into our bathroom. Master bathroom. Pop of red up there with a succulent in it. The beautiful chandelier that I found for such a good deal. I love it over our bathtub. I still have nails hanging up there where I had our garland, but I had to take that down. It's kind of yellow in here. There we go. So that chandelier just made this bathroom. And then that's what I put new there. That's really pretty at night, glowing in the window. That candle, I love LED candles, especially the ones that come on a timer. And then I have another little pozo in here. And then these are actually like little rose petals for your bath, but I do not use them. I just use them for decor. I got those at TJ Maxx. And I still have more of those, but that's all that would fit in that little tray. And then that's a candle that I made. And then over here, I have this pretty little arrangement. And nothing over here has changed since Christmas. I still have that wreath with the red bow, but it still looked Valentine's Day-ish to me. And then I have this little sign I was telling y'all about, the Grow Old Along With Me, the Best Is Yet To Be sign. And then this has all stayed the same. I still have Christmas spirit set out, the hand soap, because it still smells so good and I still want to use it up. And then everybody always asks me about this. I got this from Home Goods, and I just put my face oils, skincare oils, and home remedies over there. And then I'll spin around this way so you can see everything again. And then the only thing that I did in my shower was I added this cute little Valentine's Day plate to the bottom of this little pozo plant. And so that is the only thing in the shower that's changed. And so now we'll just walk through here. We'll go back into the living room and dining room. I need to go slow for y'all. Gonna make y'all dizzy. And that's really all I have to share with y'all today. I hope that y'all have a great Valentine's Day week. Let me know in the comments below what your favorite decorating idea that I had for y'all this time was. I don't know what my favorite is, but this backsplash is one of it. I will tell you that. And don't forget to go check out Miranda and her Valentine's Day home tour. Again, tell her I sent you. Show her some love. I hope that y'all have a wonderful Valentine's Day week. I'm celebrating all week long. We have lots of fun things planned. I just love celebrating any holiday. I know we're going to get a few comments on, well, you should celebrate love every day. And trust me, I do. But to be able to have a holiday, to be able to decorate with hearts and just let it be all about love is in the air. Y'all let me know some of the fun things y'all are doing this week, how you're celebrating Valentine's Day or Galentine's Day or whatever you're doing. Give me some ideas to do. Like I said, I want to celebrate all week, do a lot of fun things.
I have my little Valentine's Day bucket list over here ready to go.
So I hope that you'll have a wonderful week, and I will see y'all on the next one. See y'all later.